Well, it's a pleasure and an honor to have John Coltrane in front of our microphone here. And John, I gotta be abrupt with you. I gotta say like this, that your playing has been turned antenna-like, unbeautiful, on just about everything you can think of. And since the playing mirrors the personality, I guess you have some personal thoughts of that kind to say.
Let me follow you again. You said my plan has on what?
I didn't say that. I said what the critics said.
Said, oh, well, they seem to think that it's an angry sort of thing. It's real. Some of them do. I don't know. But the critics here.
You feel angry?
No, I don't. I was talking to a fellow today, and I told him that the reason I play so many, it sounds, maybe it sounds angry because I'm trying so many things at one time, you see. Like, I haven't sorted them out. I have a whole bag of things that I'm trying to work through and get the one essential, you know.
Would you say that you're trying to play everything you hear one time or something like that?
No, there are some set things that I know, some devices that I know, harmonic devices that I know, that will take me out of the ordinary path, you see, if I use these. But I haven't played them enough, and I'm not familiar with them enough yet to take the one single line through them. So I play all of them, you know, trying to acclimate my ears so I can hear, you know.
In the album liners of your latest LP, that was the Giant Steps LP, which we have played quite a lot on this show, you claim that you were trying to get as I understood it, a more beautiful sound.
Well, I hope to play not necessarily a more beautiful sound, though I would like to, you know, just say tone-wise, I would like to be able to produce a more beautiful sound. But now I'm primarily interested in trying to work what I have, what I know, down into a more lyrical line. You know, that's what I mean by beautiful, right? More lyrical, so to be, you know, easily understood.
I'm sure our listeners are, as they are mainly collectors of Coltrane records, I'm sure they like to hear you express one thought of what you think is listenable among your whole production.
Oh, you mean of the albums that
yeah.
I made? Oh, I like Blue Train myself.
I figured you would.
There's such a good band on there, you know.
That's a real dangerous album, man.
It was a good recording.
How do you feel about this last quartet recording here, Giant Steps?
I think that was my best quartet recording so far. With the exception of maybe Soul Train, I'd put them both about the same.
How would you say working with Miles Davis has influenced you stylistically?
Well, it has led me into most of the things that I'm doing now. Yeah.
He has had a major stranglehold on you in that matter. I mean, he made you play the way you do, or you got a chance to play like
well,
you
I've
do.
Been free. I've been so free here, you know, that almost anything I want to try is... I'm welcome to do it, you know, so that's the freedom has helped me.
I heard you were
experiment.
Splitting the Miles Quintet here and then trying something on your own.
Yes, I am.
How's that? With whom?
I have several men in mind, but I haven't selected the side men yet, you know. I'm going to try
with
the quartet.
Would you feel like working with a quartet?
Yeah, to begin with, and maybe in several weeks after I start, I might add a fifth man.
John, which tenor players do you think have influenced you, if any at all?
All of them. I would say all of them. But,
do you have a personal favorite, I mean, like you put on a record when you were at home and relaxing and so on?
Well, Sonny Rollins is, I think he's an outstanding tenor man today.
That is exactly what Sonny Rollins told me on this show about you. So
that's usually, you know,
seems to
my
be
man,
a mutual
you know.
Admiration society
yeah,
here.
Well, he's great. I mean, you know.
Mm-hmm.
And Of course, in the formative days, well, like years ago, it was Dexter Gordon that actually was a major.
You do have a strong feeling for tradition, haven't you?
I guess so. I mean, I would like to even make it stronger. Mm-hmm. You know, I like to strengthen my roots, so to say, mm-hmm. you know, because I didn't start at the beginning, and there's a whole lot back there that's, you know, that all young musicians should
have.
Do you,
privately, I mean, when you're listening, you go back there, I mean, just on your own account and listen?
Well, I don't have many records in that era now, but I do plan to get them. I plan to include that in my repertoire, you know, all these old traditional things. I've been trying recently to search myself, you know, and try to find things that are reminiscent that sound like those things. But I'm really going to do some work on that soon.
Well, John, it seems like you're on with the Miles Davis Quintet here, and thank you very much for taking the time and dropping in on
You're welcome. Thank you very much. Enjoy.